Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Thank you for tuning in. Today we're going to work on a wine refrigerator, one of those small coolers. I guess it didn't work anymore, so the owner just thought that they would just go ahead and get rid of it. But instead, we are going to try to fix it today. It's a Newair. We're gonna get to see if we can get it running. All right, Brian, what's going on with this thing today?
I've had enough. It's got a trouble code.
What's the trouble code? It's making that sound?
Yeah, that's what it says, EH. When you call Newair and ask them about trouble codes, they tell you that is a problem in the wiring and you need a new one. And if you ask for any specifics, they can't give you. But they are happy to sell you a new cooler. So we're going to tuck into her and see if we can figure out what the underlying problem is. We have a couple of points of interest. One of them here being the cold control or thermostat. The wiring harness feeds up through here and it starts back here at the main control board.
Where does the wiring harness feed through?
This hinge.
Actual hinge?
Yeah, that,
so there's wiring going through there? Okay.
And then it comes back, you follow it back, it comes to here.
Okay.
So we're gonna hook it up and see what we can figure out what's going on with the harness. See if we can't clear this trouble code and get her to do the hunka chunka.
So what's the cover you're taking off?
This is for the main control. And let's see. That those wires feed up to the thermostat that's mounted on the front door. They come through, this cover just pops off.
So the hinge cover just hides all the wiring?
Yep.
Okay.
Figure out how to get that off, which is gonna take a little force.
So you're gonna pop off the front cover?
Yeah, well, the nice thing is, actually, let me kill power to it. The nice thing is, it's already broken, so we can't really break it anymore. And they've actually already ordered a replacement unit, so.
Now, where'd this come from?
Just a friend of the channel. We might be getting in there. All right, she just mounts on some tabs. And there's the other end of our wiring harness. All right, and they do list a little description here. There's the LED. There's power to the board, and then what I'm assuming is the temp control or temperature probe.
All right, so I'm holding a lead over here on this side. What do you got going on the back side there, Brian?
Well, we're just ohming through this wiring harness to see if we can figure out where the problem is. And so far, everything's checked out fine. So all of our wiring is intact, which is, according to the factory, where the problem is. So we're gonna move on. The only other thing that I can think of to check is on the inside, is the temperature probe, which is here. Let go of that and I'll show you what the temperature probe is. It is right there.
Okay.
So now we're going to see if we can somehow gain access to that. I'm not sure how it's mounted, but we'll figure it out.
So you just unclipped it?
Yep. There's our thermistor. Now, see, what can we come up with? I've got another thermistor.
All right, so we removed the old thermistor, and what do you got going now?
Well, I've got another thermistor. It's off of a ice cream case, and in all likelihood, it's not going to be the right resistance for this case. But
can you grab the end of it?
To
show everybody.
It's just a temperature probe. It's obviously a commercial one. It's a little more substantial.
Okay.
But the try to hook it up. Limited space that we have. And power it up and see if we can clear that.
So you're just putting the clips on the leads?
Yeah, I'm just using alligator clips because I don't want to damage the factory connection until I confirm that this is the issue.
Now, are you just going to go back to the control panel to see if it's throwing a code?
Well, probably would have. My lead slipped off. I'll reconnect and try again.
All right, we got the leads on there. Gonna plug it back in.
Hey, we got a display. No longer saying, ugh.
All right, so that is the problem then.
It would appear. Let's button the rest of this back up and see what it does.
It's all back together.
Well, what we can do is take the that thermocouple and splice it in and reconnect it to the harness as a permanent connection with using the factory connector.
So you just set the temp?
Yeah, I just turned it down all the way. Currently it's showing 86 on the display and we've got it set to 39.
So give it some time, see if it cools down.
Yep, all we gotta do is keep an eye on the evaporator. It should start chilling down.
What's that?
Another thermocouple.
So it's reading essentially 81.8,
yeah,
or it's dropping slowly.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the main thing I'm checking is to see, are we in the ballpark with this one up here, and it's reading 86, but this one is a little more, I would say, accurate than that. So I'll let it run.
Well, it does look like it's going down.
Yeah.
All right, we've given it a few minutes, and now the temp is 81, so it definitely is coming down.
Yeah, it's definitely running, and so we're going to disconnect what we've done and try to make a permanent repair. In the meantime, we'll do a little bit of cleanup, and everything's back together. So relatively pretty quick fix. And you know, if you have one of these Newairs and it's showing that EH trouble code, you know, get with us if you need information on the you know, the resistance of that thermocouple, and we'll get back to you and let you know what it is.
It's icing up nicely, huh?
Yeah. So she's definitely doing the hunka chunka now. So, like I said, we just need to make the repair permanent and take out our patch wires and do something that is a permanent repair. See what we can come up with for mounting on the new thermocouple, because you'll see it's quite a bit more substantial. So as a result, it's going to be, we're going to have to modify the mountings, but we'll figure it out. I'm going to go for the most obvious solution first, which is just to feed this back in where the old one used to mount. There we go.
So essentially, as long as the probe is exposed to the inside of the refrigerator.
Air temperature.
Okay.
Some times the temperature probes are embedded in the evaporator coils, but those are finned coils. And this is a, you know, like a cold plate coil. It's not a finned coil. So this one just measures air temperature and recycles the compressor based off of air temperature. So the all we have to do is make up those connections and, you know, splice that in and we're done.
Okay, from the old one to the new one?
Yeah, just so we can tap back into the existing harness, because the leads are so short, there's not really much of an opportunity to make a connection inside of there. As you can see, that white plug, that's all the slack there is in it.
All right, time to splice. All right, what do you got going, Brian?
Just
marrying up these wires, and they're not polarized, it's just measuring resistance across this thermistor. So, you know, literally just a matter of pairing the wires together, and there's no voltage on them. It, like I said, it's just that thing is, the controller on here acts like a multimeter and measures the resistance across these wires. And the alloy that this is made out of is a varying resistor based off of temperature. So
it doesn't matter which one goes to which?
No, it's not polarized, it doesn't matter.
As long as you get the two wires connected.
Yeah, as long as you get the two wires connected and they're isolated from each other. I mean, you don't want them, you know, grounded to the cabinet, but that part of the cabinet is plastic. So our only real concern is that, you know, if they touch each other, that's going to screw up the resistance reading, obviously, because it's going to be a dead short. And the old thermistor, it was, you know, in the millions of ohms, which is why we know it was the issue. So, and what we're going to try to do is leave these connections just like this. Not use wire nuts, anything, just insulate them with tape, because we don't want to make this connection any bulkier than we have to, because it has to fit in such a small area. So we're simply going to insulate them, and that will be it.
All right.
We've got them all taped up individually and then bound together. All we got to do is plug them back in.
So it's reinstalled.
Let's just go throw the shelving back in. Sad deal that they tell you, oh, you just gotta have a new one. There's nothing wrong with the refrigeration cycle, the compressor and everything works fine. It literally is a cheap little thermistor is the entire issue. You see the trouble code has gone away. It's showing the current box temperature, and it even has the factory paperwork and the key for locking the cabinet.
Well, there you have it, guys. Something that didn't work before and someone just thought they couldn't get any help fixing it, and we're able to get it back and running. Well, thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you guys on the next video. Hey, so it's been a little while, and we're just checking back to see if this thing's cooled down anymore. And it looks like the temp is really going down. All right, guys, see you on the next one.